Hey guys,
It's gonna be a little bit of a different video. If you're watching the news at all, then you know that legendary rocker Chris Cornell of Soundgarden was found dead in his hotel room in Detroit last night. As many of you know, I live in Seattle. Soundgarden is a Seattle band, and the entire city seemed very, very down today. I'm now coming from standing on the overpass by the highway where I watched the Space Needle turn their lights off at 9 o'clock tonight in remembrance of Chris. I came out later on in the day as more and more information became available that they're ruling it a suicide. I didn't know what I was gonna film today. I really didn't have anything, and I didn't put up a video today. It's Thursday as I'm recording this. This will be up tomorrow morning. Even when the world is the blackest to you, when you feel unloved, when you feel like nobody's there for you, please, please know that there's always somebody there. There's somebody in this world that needs you in their life. They have you in their life, and would be irrevocably changed without you in their life. I grew up in a rural town in Minnesota, and depression, anxiety, those type of things weren't really talked about ever. If you were depressed, people would say, "What are you depressed about? What do you have to be depressed about? You have food, you have a home, you have, clothes, you have all these things, you have nothing to be depressed about." And that's kind of how I've always taken depression. But since I've moved to Seattle and I'm in more of a metropolitan city, and I understand that depression is a very serious medical condition, and it's not taken nearly as seriously as it were. Everybody knows somebody who's dealing with depression. And if you don't suffer from depression, or anxiety, or any of these things that absolutely shackle someone and make them feel like a prisoner in their own body, it's up to people like you and people like me who don't have to deal with this to be allies, to be supportive, to be the shoulder, to be supportive, to do everything you can to lift up someone who needs just anyone to care about them. A good friend of mine posted earlier today that he had gotten some advice from one of his friends in film school, and he said that there's nothing that isn't fixable except you taking your life. That's not fixable. Once you've done that, it's gone. Everything else is fixable. It's just determining the hows and the whys and figuring out what needs to be done. You're not alone. Guys, every life is precious. Yes, even yours. I know you don't feel like it. That's the depression lying to you. That's the depression trying to win. You're fighting behind enemy lines with no support. And I guarantee you that if you look hard enough, you will find someone who cares. And if you can't, drop me a message. I'd be happy to talk to you. I'd be happy to try and help you find the help that you need. I'm gonna leave a number for suicide prevention line down in the comments if you need that. All right, that's it. No pomp and circumstance, no catchphrase at the end. I'm just gonna go ahead and end this vlog now so I can get it edited and get it up online for you guys tomorrow morning. Guys, thank you very much for watching. Again, do me that solid, hit that thumbs up, leave positive comments down in the description below for anyone who may need this in the future. And if you're one of those people who needs this right now, please know that I don't even know you. I don't have to know you. My heart breaks for you, and it aches for you. And if I could give you a hug right now, I would. You're strong. You can make it through. You've made it through every day before this. You'll make it through tonight, and you'll make it through the next night, one day at a time. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.